Mangrove trees, they protect our property from floods, and they're a big part of our ecosystem here in Florida.
But tonight, one Cape Coral canal looks like this. The trees ripped out. Neighbors along the Coral Point Canal are not happy. And tonight, the state announced it is opening an investigation into the city.
NBC2's Michael Romandi is there to find out how the city could be in trouble for messing with the mangroves.
If you take a look at this water in this Cape Coral Canal, it seems pretty ordinary, but it really hasn't been that way for the past 2 weeks. People here are frustrated that their boats just sitting on top of their docks and they can't use them. That's because this canal has been closed and debris has been filling this water for the past 2 weeks. Most of it coming from this area right across the canal here. City crews say they're removing invasive trees, but the DEP says they're removing a lot more than that potentially.
A Cape Coral canal shut down as logs and branches fill the water, residents stuck on land.
It was to the point where I couldn't even take my kayak out.
The city said they were clearing invasive trees from this land on the northern part of the 4 Mile Cove Eco Preserve. Residents say crews took out mangroves and nests for birds.
I just don't know what to say.
John Owens has not been on his new boat because of the canal's condition. He was on vacation when the trees were taken out.
First, I seen everything floating in the water. Then I came out and I looked across the canal and I couldn't believe my eyes.
The DEP sent a warning letter to the city saying they are investigating 4 potential violations from this site. The state says the city could face penalties and could be liable if they find the mangroves damaged.
They talk about giving us people citations for grass clippings and blowing your leaves in the water, but what example did they set?
Joseph Cruz lives right across the canal from the site. He says city workers finished installing this yellow screen along the banks this morning.
Should have been up since day one, since before they even started.
The city had 2 employees going door to door today to talk to residents. Cruz says they were never told before Cruz started, and it's too late now.
We enjoyed the view. That's why we came here. And now it's gone. I want to see concrete action. And I want to know that this is a protected environment and that it's going to remain a protected environment, that they're going to do whatever it takes to restore it.
Asked the city today if the crews that worked here behind me were ordered to take everything out or if it was a mistake, they would not go into details about what happened here behind me. Reporting in Cape Coral, Michael Raimondi, NBC2.